刚刚竞选连任成功的纽约市长白思豪，在过去的四年中最大的功绩之一，就是在纽约市成功推广了免费全民学前班，让全市四岁以上的孩子都能接受早期教育。而他连任后最重要的事，就是在2021年前，让全市32个学区中的8个进一步实施免费三岁学前班计划。但是白思豪的计划面临着两个问题。首先，谁将为这个免费的三岁学前班计划付钱？按照白思豪的提案，这一项目所需的7亿元款项将由联邦、纽约州府和纽约市府共同承担。实际上，白思豪也曾提出过增加富人税来资助学前班项目，但却遭到了州府的否决。而在联邦和州府愿意提供经费的前提下，将孩子的入学年龄再往前推是否还有必要？其次，从目前四岁学前班的实施过程来看，仍有很多孩子面临着公校或社区免费学前班名额不足、私校学费难以负担的困境。三岁学前班的实施是否会加重免费学前班资源紧张的问题？而这几年来，全民学前班又是否真的达到了预期的目标？为此，我们采访了纽约华人家长会会长黄德旺，听一听他的说法。
I think that a lot of times kids are not prepared for school when they come in. If they don't go to a UPK, they come into schools and they're still struggling to learn social issues. They're learning how to share. They're learning how to learn and listen in a classroom. And just getting them in a school setting, getting them in a classroom environment with other children, is a very important part of the social growth. I think, you know, most people will tell you for pre-K, and the same thing for the threes program. The idea is not so much that we're trying to give kids advanced work, but it's more to put them in the right position to learn how to learn. I agree that there's not enough pre-K spots in public schools. There's just not enough room in the classrooms. So, you know, the mayor's initiative for UPK was to help open up more of these kind of private UPK schools, you know, that are not in a public school building. It's great that the kids can go sign up for this, and part of the tuition is free. It's taken care of by the city. But if you're not in a, you know, you do have to be careful about which ones you sign up for, because, you know, some of them are great and some of them are not so great. But here's the thing. At least it's available and it's free. So the objective is to get your child into that type of school setting earlier. And the earlier they get in, typically the more successful they are later down the road.